Welcome back to the channel Gadgets for Gentlemen. In today's video, I'm going to show you two automatic watches that could be a great watch purchase if you are into this hobby freshly. If you are starting this hobby, or maybe you don't want to collect watches, but you just want one automatic watch. I think these watches are quite amazing. And in this video, I will compare these two watches a little bit side by side. So let's jump into it. Here on the left, we have the following watch. This is the SNZ G15J1. This one is made in Japan, and it features the caliber 7S36 automatic watch movement, 23 jewels, water resist 100 meters. And this little piece was on top of the strap. On the right, we're dealing with the SNK 803 K2. This is a slightly different movement, the 7S26, water resist 30 meters. And both of these watches, they feature Hartlex crystal. So let's look at these watches a little bit closer. So here on the left, we have a slightly larger field style watch. We're dealing here with 42 millimeters across. We're dealing here with 42 millimeters across. That's the diameter. And this watch can be found in black with a matching strap, blue, olive, and beige. And they all have different numbers, different reference numbers when it comes to different colors. And this is the G15. And as you can see, it comes on this fabric strap, which in my opinion is quite nice. It consists of two pieces. It has a keeper and it has this satin brushed buckle. And this one doesn't read any Seiko marking. And as you can see, the case is also satin brushed. We can see here at the bottom, this high polish, even here at the bottom also. But the top part of the case is satin finished, including the crown. And the watch has an exhibition case back, which means we have a screw down case back. But unlike most watches that have a non-visible case back, this case back is see-through. So right in here, we can see the watch movement, which is such a nice feature, as you can see right here. And I told you that the caliber of this movement is called the 7S36. And it's a workhorse movement, like it's very sturdy. And the movement, it does not allow for hand winding or hacking, but it does allow for a quick change of the date. And I think the best part about this watch has to be the dial. I think the dial is very nice and very legible. It's easy to read. And another great thing about this watch is that 100 meters of water resist, which is quite a lot for an everyday watch. We have the date wheel here at the 3 o'clock. We have plenty of lume on the markers, and we have nice hands. We have an applied Seiko shield at the 12 o'clock position. And here it proudly reads made in Japan, because this is a J model. There's also K models, which are a little cheaper, and they don't have the made in Japan written on the dial. So I went for the made in Japan because I think for that extra little money, I think it is maybe $20 more. I think it's just nicer. I don't really know the difference between J and K, but I really like the made in Japan marking on the dial. I think it makes the watch a little bit more special. So here we're dealing with a 42 millimeter case, a lug width of 22 millimeters. So you can wear it on any 22 millimeter strap, for example, leather or a NATO. Thickness, we're dealing here with 11.7, and a lug to lug distance, which is quite long actually, of 48.5 millimeters. And therefore, I will advocate that I think this watch is perfect if you have a medium to large wrist size. So my wrist, they measure 6.3 inches, which I consider small. For me personally, I think this watch is a little bit too large, and therefore I will show you the smaller watch. But first of all, let me say the specifications of this watch, in my opinion, are slightly better because of that 100 meter water resist. Just to conclude that. And also, I think the strap is of a higher quality compared to the strap that we can find for this little man. This again is the 803. This is a 37 millimeter field style watch, also satin finished. Also this part and this part is polished, and the back is polished. Also the case back is screwed down, exhibition also see-through, and here we can have a look at the movement, which is very similar. But this is the 7S26. This part, yeah, this is the 7S26. Don't ask me what's the key difference. I think these movements are very similar. This watch also does not allow for hacking or hand winding, but it does allow for quickly changing the date. Yeah, another difference actually between these two watches is the bigger watch, the SNZ G15, has quite a nice crown at the 3 o'clock. It's easy to grip, it's pull and push. It's quite easy to work with. The crown on the smaller watch is more hidden here at the 4 o'clock position. And also this is pull and push, but it's located at the 4 o'clock, so it's very discreet. I think it's quite comfortable because that way you don't bump into things, but operating the crown it takes a little bit more effort because it's a little bit more difficult to operate. So this watch, we're dealing here with 37 millimeters diameter, which makes this watch quite easy to wear on smaller size wrists. The strap is a 18 millimeter strap. I think the quality of the strap is average, as you can see here. I haven't worn it much, but it already starts to tear this material a little bit. Strap looks nice, but I'm not a fan. I'd rather wear this one on a NATO. But I just wanted to show you how these watches should arrive on your doorstep. So I left them on the original straps. So 37, 18, thickness of only 10.7. So there's a whole millimeter thinner compared to the bigger brother. So for me, that's a bonus. And the lug width is only 42.9 millimeters. So that's a whole difference, as you can see here, between those 48.5 and 42.9. So that's like 6 millimeters difference, or 5.5. And the key difference here between these two watches is this watch is only 30 meters water resist. So I would not swim with this watch probably. But I think washing your hands should be no big deal. Again, here it reads water resist. Now, I think it's time to throw them on the wrist. And I will also include some daylight shots in the very end of this video. Here we have the 803 on my 6.3 inches wrist. As you can see, there's plenty of adjustment holes. And I wear it in the second adjustment hole, this one. As you can see, this clasp is signed with the Seiko logo. And we can see those buckles are also satin finished, which is not the same color of the case, but it's quite similar. So that's done quite nicely by Seiko. And this is what it looks like on a 6.3 inches wrist. I will also include some daylight shots in the very end of the video. But I think this looks rather nice. It's very compact. And again, also with this watch, It comes in different colorways, so I'm sure you will find a piece that fits with your style. I really like this beige or cream dial. I'm not a fan of this strap. I usually wear it on a green NATO strap, and I think that looks quite nice. Now let's proceed with the bigger brother, the SNG G15, and throw this one on the wrist. I already feel that the fabric strap just feels nicer. This feels softer compared to this material. This is very sturdy, but also, yeah, it's not that comfortable on the wrist, unfortunately. But this strap is much more like, it feels a bit like a seat belt material, but in a nice way. It has keepers, and this is what it looks like on a 6.3 inches wrist. And somehow, I don't know why, but it almost seems like it's larger than my wrist size. You're talking about the lug to lug. It looks almost like it's overhanging my wrist. I'm not sure if it's the case, it's almost there. It's a great looking watch with a ton of specs, and it's quite affordable. I will leave links to these items in the descriptions. For me personally, I think the SNZ G15 is a better watch if you have larger wrists, again, medium to large. For the smaller wrists, I think the smaller brother, the 803, is a better choice, or the 809, for example, because it's much more comfortable on the wrist. The SNG also has better specs in terms of the water resistance. Other than that, these watches are quite similar. And that's also the reason for making this video, to show you those differences. I'm going to stick with the smaller brother. This one, I think it's quite nice to have a small watch in this day and age of huge watches. But then again, I'm a big fan of this watch. I also want to tell you that there's another category, a new family of Seiko watches. I'm here talking about the lineup SRP G33, also different colorways. It's a new watch in the Seiko family. It features hacking and hand winding. I think it's NH35 automatic movement. It's a little bit more expensive. But the great thing about that watch, I think, is the size, which is, I think, a 39 millimeters, which makes it fit between these two watches. So this is 42, 37, and the new edition is a 39, I think. It has drilled lugs. It has a domed Hardlex mineral crystal. I think it would be much, I think it would have been much better with a sapphire crystal. And it's a bit of a price jump. So if you don't care about a hacking hand winding movement and you prefer a flat crystal, then still the SNG G15, also for a lower retail price, might be the best choice. But if you want a slightly smaller case diameter, if you want an improved watch movement, if you want drilled lugs, then also have a look at that new lineup, the SRP G33. Yes, I forgot to do one more take. I forgot to mention the box of these watches. I purchased these watches of Creation Watches, and they come in this very generic little pouch with the user instructions, with the warranty card, but no Seiko box. If you purchase them anywhere else, like Amazon, they should come with a pretty simple watch box. The second thing that I wanted to show you, and I forgot to record, is the weight of these watches. So here on the left, the SNK 803 on the original fabric strap weighs about 61 grams. Doesn't weigh a thing. If we go to the bigger brother, the SNZ G15 on the original fabric strap weighs 81 grams. So there's a difference in terms of weight of 20 grams between these two watches on the original fabric straps. And I guess if you wear it on a NATO, weight might even go down a little bit.
because you get rid of these buckles and so on. Forgive me about this take, I forgot to record it, but here we have it. That's the weight of these two watches.
So in this clip, I'm going to show you what these watches look like in a dark environment. Here, it's not pitch black, but at least I can demonstrate to you a little bit of that loom. That's the point of this shot, to show you that the watches, they have loom applied. I think the loom on the right, the bigger one, is slightly better. And let's loom it up a little bit. Here I'm using just a simple flashlight to bring a little bit more light to that luminescent materials. And let's have a quick look which one is stronger. Maybe they're equally in terms of strength. And let's see what parts are loomed. So there we go. So there we go, here on the right, what we can see is a tiny, tiny bit of loom on the second hand tip. We have loom on the hour markers, but not on the hours itself. So we have it all around, but not on the hours itself. And here on the left, we can see tiny, tiny little bits of loom on the hour markers and on the hands. Definitely, I think, in terms of the loom, the bigger one is much more legible because the amount of luminescent paint is much more. Also, the hour markers are bigger. On the little brother, the SNK-803, it's barely visible. The hands are quite visible, but the hour markers itself, they hardly light up. Let me do it one more time, and that's it. So clearly the bigger one is quite visible, although not as strong as my dive watches, and the left one is hardly visible, but there is luminescent materials.
So that is the end of the video. Let me know what you think. I'm curious if you're going for the SNZ G15 or another model, or maybe you're going for this smaller family, the SNK-803 family. Or maybe you're going for the new lineup, the SRP G33. Please let me know in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day and see you soon.